Hi all, so I am again here with another topic on AS400. So this time I am going to discuss how to identify whether any job is interactive or batch in RPG AS400 program. So yesterday I created one program where I discussed the same thing, but that was in CL programming, but this time in RPG programming. So let me tell you, we have one API available from the IBM, that is QUSR job I, retrieve job information, which gives us the job information on the available different formats. So I'm using the basic format job I0100, but there are several other advanced format as well which are available that you can use based upon your need. That is 0150, 20, 30, 40 till 9. So they are different formats which are available after this format, and having much more information than this, including this information and other information. So we don't need those formats right now, because I just need to check whether my job is interactive or batch. So that's why I just defined the prototype of this API. So if you want to check, since this is a program, just do work object. So you will find the object of this programming QSys library provided by IBM. So I'm just calling this API. So this has this much parameter, where receiver variable is basically this format, this DS, which we are gonna passing to this API. This is the length of this DS, job I0100, or you can say size of this. This is the format which we are passing. So the format name would be job I0100, which we are using right now. This is the job name. So the job name either could be the current job in which we are basically running our program, that is interactive always, and also we can pass a job name. So we can, what we can do, we can take an input parameter of the qualified job name, and just we can check for that job name as well, whether the job is in interactive mode or in batch mode. This is the internal job ID, which must be blank passed. This is the error DS. So if any error occurs, this will be DS would get populated. So this is the structure of the DS, where I would get the message ID and text for that, and these are the bytes provided and available, and this is reserved for the future use. Now you can see this format, which is again bytes returned, bytes available, job name, job user, job number, job internal ID, job status, job type. So job type param or job type sub DS fields will give me the exact result. So not, it's not one or zero in this case. For this format, it will return me I or B. So job subtype, reserved job run priority, time slice, default wait, but so these are the sub fields of the DS job I0100, which I defined here. So I just have to define the format and its subfield, and this error DS and its subfield, which is part of this, and this, and you can see, then I defined the format name. So either I can directly pass job I0100 here, but I am passing the that with using the variable, so that in future if I want to use some other format, I would be declaring that format as well in this program, and I don't need to comment this format, and I would be able to use that format. So I just have to change that format name here only, and I have to define that format, job I0150 or 20 30, whatever I am gonna using, and then that will be referred here automatically. So that's the internal job name, which is blank. This is the job name. So if I am passing star right now, I'm commenting this. This is some job which is running in batch mode right now in the system. So I'll be share. This is just for an example to show you that are we able to find that job is in batch job or not. So that's why I took this. You can directly pass an input parameter to this program with this job name. So this job name consists of the job name. First 10 positions would be job name without trimming it, and then the username and the job number. So in case I would be passing the wrong job name, then what happens, I would be getting some error CPF C03, something like that. I would try here to show you that error as well, which would be populated in the error DS. So now here you can see I'm calling this QUSR job I in API. So what you can do, you can change the name here, because like retrieve job information API or something like that, and you can call that as well. But I took the name as same as the program. I'm passing the job, the format job I0100 and its size, and then the format name which is job I0100, then the job name which is currently star, that is current job, internal job name is blank, and this is also blank right now. Let me compile this. Program is compiled successfully. Let me debug this. Just set the breakpoint at line number 1 and then call this program. We can also, there is one point that we can also use this API in our CL program, so that we could also find the job which is in batch or in interactive mode from CL as well. But there is much we can directly use retrieve job A command in the CL to find out whether the job is in batch or interactive. That's very easy than this. We don't need to call this API, we can directly use that command. So let me show you. So this is just a prototype, so we won't be able to see the value because this is not an interface parameters defined here. So this is just a definition. So these are the DSS which are currently blank or not initialized right now. This is the format which is again not initialized. Just come down. So format name is this, internal job name is blank, job name is star. So now if I look at the format name or this format, you can see bytes returned are this, bytes available are this. This is the job name, this is the job user, this is the job number. So we are able to find the job details as well. This is currently active job. Now you can see the job type is I, so which means that this is an interactive job. So what happened, it will display interactive job. Now if I call is this program again, and now what I'll do, I'll evaluate job name as this job during debug. Now you will see the job details. So this is the job name, job user, job number which I passed, and this is active currently, and this its job type is batch. Now it will go to the this section and it will print badge, or it will display badge job. So what I was saying, that I was talking about an error which you may receive. So be please take care of that, that whenever you are passing the job name, that must be qualified and must be starts with the job name. Then without trimming that, after 10 spaces or 10 places, you will be writing the username, and then whatever blanks come, if the job, if the username is not till up to 10 length, then the blanks would be there, and then the job number. So if I pass eval job name as this, so for example, if suppose someone passed like this, someone passed the job name as first as username, then job name, then number, which is wrong. If it gets passed, you can see no job details retrieved. Now, no job details retrieved. So what we need to do in this case, we need to print the error. You can see this LLDS gets populated. CPF3C53. So CPF3C53 tells that the job is invalid. Job name is invalid basically. You can see this job name is invalid. So you need to pass the correct details. So using this way, we can check whether a job is interactive or in batch in RPG ASP.NET. We can call this API in CL as well, but there is no need to call this API in CL because we have another API retrieve job, or we have another command which we can directly use, which is very simple, that is retrieve job A in our CL program. You can check my video on the channel which I created for the same thing in CL ASP.NET. So that's all in this video. Thank you and have a nice time.